Hello and welcome to another edition of Air Force Basketball along with head coach Dave Pilipovich. I'm Brian German. Boy, we've got a lot to talk about. There was a lot of holidays and three basketball games, coach. But first of all, how were the holidays for you?
Holidays were short. Yeah. So we went from California to Florida, and in between we opened some presents and had a little Christmas turkey, but it was good.
That's good. So you did actually take some time to
we did.
Celebrate
3 hours. No. It was good.
Hey, it's short but good. Anyway, let's start with UC Riverside and a team who went in and you get the victory in that ball game.
It was a good game for us because we were on a long layoff. Had a chance to get to California, play a game. Good defensive team, very physical team, and came out with the win. Mike Lyons scored well for us in that game. Had good contributions from a lot of guys. It was a good win. Had some alums at the game. It was great to see some former players. So it was a good trip for us.
Yeah, and then you continue the trip. You go down to Florida.
Yes.
And I don't think anyone expected the Air Force Falcons to beat Florida. You know, a ranked team, a highly ranked team on their court. But how do you feel about the way your team played, and especially the first half? I mean, you're right in there with
played them. Well in the first half, played well beginning of the second half, and then our defense couldn't sustain their size and their strength inside. They almost shoot the ball 70% inside in the second, or shoot the ball 70% in the second half because a lot of inside touches and scores. But a very, very good team and excited about how we played in spurts during that game. I was hoping to carry that over into the Richmond game. Unfortunately, it didn't. But caught a Richmond team that lost three games in a row that was well prepared and shot the ball really well against us.
Of course, the Spiders were without one of their key players, but unfortunately, you would think that would be a good thing.
Yes.
When the guy who replaces him comes in and shoots lights out.
Yeah, returning rookie of the year in Atlantic 10, shot the ball. We still haven't guarded him. I mean, he was really good. Talented team, very well coached. Played with a chip on his shoulder because, again, they were coming off three straight losses, and we're not going to get another loss prior to Atlantic 10 play. And they executed better than we did and made shots, and it was a long night for us.
Did you give Chris Mooney any trouble after the game? I mean, you shouldn't treat the Falcons like that.
They told him that. Right? And they're returning the game next year, and I told him we will think about that until that young man graduates. Maybe we'll postpone the game. But he was really good to us, had some very complimentary things to say about our team as he watched and prepped for the game. So it was good to hear. Gave us some things that we need to work on. So I'm glad we played both games.
Yeah. Okay. So do you feel pretty good now? I mean, that's a pretty tough schedule.
Yeah.
I think probably the toughest we've had in quite some time
here
for Air Force to get ready for the Mountain West Conference.
We do. And as we head into Mountain West Conference play, starting with Nevada, and the league is stronger than it's ever been. But I think we're prepared to play those type of opponents. That's why we did it. We're excited about playing the first game at home.
You got the first game at home Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, against the Nevada Wolfpack. Mm-hmm. Nevada comes in, of course, the first year in the Mountain West in basketball. But this is a good basketball team.
It is. They're led by two guards. Malik Story is leading the team in scoring, who's a former player at Indiana University, transferred. Mm-hmm. Deontay Burton, who's a returning WAC player of the year, who's now coming into Mountain West Conference. Two very strong, big guards that can score a lot of points, size and some length inside. So a lot of things that we need to work on, that we've been working on to be very good Wednesday against a good Wolfpack team.
Yeah. Do you change your lineup, put different guards out there?
No, but we may change some things, how we're guarding some situations, guarding some people. We'll play some more players. I thought our younger players were really good in the Richmond game, so we need to get them more minutes. They're very competitive and played very strong. So we've got the luxury of playing a lot of guys, and we may have to utilize our bench a little more.
It doesn't get easy, though. Mountain West Conference
doesn't.
I mean, this is pretty incredible. And you get Nevada Wolfpack, then you have to go on the road and take on UNLV. Do you feel like you're going from the frying pan to the fire?
We do. But this is what we signed up for. Mm-hmm. We knew this was coming. We're excited about the opportunities. We were picked last in the preseason poll, mm-hmm. so we have a little chip on our shoulder. You know, that's not where we want to be. It's not where we're going to be. But every night's going to be a battle for us. I mean, some great teams, some great players. Should be exciting Mountain West Conference season.
It certainly will be. We'll be out there Wednesday night. Come out and join us. See the Falcons take on Nevada. That's a 7 o'clock tip-off. We'll see you out there then. Then we'll be back here with some highlights for you of a couple of games the next time we meet up with Coach P. We'll see you then.
Thank you.